Now in my hand is the wave 3. You'll be shocked to know that the wave 2 that came, that wave has already gone into wave 3. What could a mobile phone company like Samsung have done so quickly that they've changed into the wave 3? What are the differences? What is the good? What is the bad? And a little bit of rumors to do with what happens with the Bada OS, all coming up right now.
This one is different from the usual plastic phones of Samsung. A metallic aluminium casing does seem neat and stylish and very slim. In fact, it is just 9.9 mm at its slimmest point. An almost unibody design with minimalistic keys. The power key is on the right and the left panel has the volume rocker. The USB port and the 3.5 mm jack is at the bottom, which is not the most convenient position for the audio jack. A 4-inch Super AMOLED screen dominates the front and packs 480 into 800 pixel resolution. It uses a pentile matrix display, which takes away from the sharpness, making the display just average. Below the screen, a massive home key between capacitive call keys. Flip the phone around and there is a 5-megapixel camera with LED flash. The vertical bars on either sides of the screen have all the tools required for picture settings. We found the picture quality pretty good, but it also has a VGA front camera for video calls. The phone is powered by a massive 1.4 GHz processor, which allows speedy multitasking. Wave 3 runs on Samsung's homegrown Bada 2 operating system. Going by the rumor mill, Bada may get merged with the Intel-backed Tizen operating system. If this happens, Bada will continue as an operating system for low and mid-range phones, while the premium handsets will run on Tizen. Back to the phone now, Bada is a lot like Android. Teamed up with a TouchWiz UI, it's not a bad combination. Samsung has introduced the Live Panel, which is a scrollable menu for widgets. Choose their order and enable or disable them as you please. The gallery has also been modified with a nifty page turn effect, not many pictures editing tools besides cropping and rotating. The phone also supports Chaton, which is Samsung's version of BBM and iMessage to send free text to your friends. But sadly, there are a few apps to download on the Bada operating system. Samsung really needs to step it up here. The memory of the phone is 4GB expandable to 32GB with a card. The card slot is not hot swappable though. It runs on a 1500 mAh battery and is priced at around 18,000 rupees. Let's take a quick look at some of the key features between the Wave 2 and 3. The screen of the Wave 3 is bigger at 4 inches than the Wave 2, which is at 3.7 inches. The internal memory has also been boosted from 4GB to 2GB in Wave 2. Most importantly, the operating system has also been upped from Bada 1.2 to Bada 2.0. The processor is speedier at 1.4 GHz processor, better than the 1 GHz in Wave 2.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.